was born in Hibbing, the same place as Bob Dylan and Kevin McHale. Those are the two most famous people. Well, by the end of the night, there'll be a third guy, and he'll have his name engraved on the Stanley Cup later. An emotional guy, and he's the first guy here every day for practice, every day for the games, Mike Peluso. And he'll be one of the last guys to leave tonight. This will be his longest and probably his happiest day ever in hockey.
You know, you're known as a scrapper and a fighter, and you wonder if you ever have a chance to play in the National Hockey League. He credits Mike Keenan for giving him a chance to play. You have to try to enjoy the moment. My goodness. It's just, that's what it means in this sport to be able to win it. You've got some people like Tom Troisky there with a smile. You've got Mike Peluso, can't control his emotions. And you've got Jacques Lemaire with 225. He's still coaching.
Constantino. On to Bob Airy and back in. The chant is the same one that began in the parking lot at about 1:30 this afternoon. Let's go Devils. Cicerelli with one that was deflected into the seats by Martin Brodeur. And again, play stopped. Moving in,
first minute of play.
Nearly got a shot away, and then McKay fired one wide.
Peluso's lines on the ice. I wonder if he can't play because of his emotion level right now.
It would not be surprising.
No. Congratulations to the New Jersey Devils and their fans and their great staff. This is very well deserved.
The Devils locker room, a newspaper quote, had the following passage underlined. We have the heart of a champion. You cannot measure it. You can only feel it. A quote by Hakeem Olajuwon of the NBA champion Houston Rockets. Well, they're going to have a few quotes in the papers tomorrow.
Let's not forget about Detroit, their Red Wings, their coaching staff, and their great hockey city. They battled to get here for the first time in a long time, but they were beaten by a much better hockey club. Much better hockey club.
The championship to New Jersey. The Devils win the Stanley Cup.